How's it going, everyone? This is Ness. And over the next few videos, what we're going to do is we're going to cover exactly what Forex is all about, so that way you can truly master high-frequency Forex later. So let's first talk about the evolution of money. Before, back in the days, what we used to do was barter. What does that mean? In order for us to exchange goods for other goods, right, or exchange commodities for other goods, we simply had to make fair trades. We had to barter. After a while, the whole barter system started to evolve. Next thing you know, there were evidence of trade records. You can look at this as the beginning of receipts. So that way people can actually track some of their trade records. And so before, from just simply bartering and just going off the top of our head, who owes us what, how many transactions we did, where are we generating the majority of our business from, down to the exact number, it was a little harder, all right, if you just bartered without the evidence of trade records. So obviously that system started to evolve. As we advanced in time, we developed coinage. Now, coinage is basically the beginning of actual money. As time went on, we then developed banknotes, which is paper money. All right, so from coinage to banknotes, which is the beginning of paper money. And now in the digital age, of course, we now have digital money on top of banknotes. So let's talk about the power of the dollar. In 1879, the dollar was pretty much held to the classical gold standard, which means that the currency itself was backed by gold. The money itself was backed by gold. In 1913, the Federal Reserve was allowed to print money with 40% reserve. So it wasn't 100% backed by gold, but it was backed by gold 40%. By the time World War I came along, there was more printed currency than gold. So at that time, paper was no longer redeemable in gold. From 1922 to 1944, we were on the gold exchange standard. So in 1944, that was the Bretton Woods system, which pretty much meant that currencies out there in the world was backed by the dollar. And the dollar was supposed to be backed by gold. And because of that, there were fixed exchange rates. Going into 1971 to 1973, there were now 12 times more dollars than gold. So what ended up happening was other countries were starting to pick up that, hey, the dollar isn't really truly backed up by gold. So other countries started to request their gold back. Because remember, the currencies out there was backed by the dollar, and the dollar was supposed to be backed by gold. So when other countries exchanged their paper for gold, the U.S. lost half of their gold. And at that point, the U.S. dollar was no longer on the gold standard and officially becomes a fiat currency. What is fiat? Faith. Okay? Faith that the U.S. currency is backed by gold. So at that time, all currencies, exchange rates, becomes a free-floating system. Before, it was a fixed exchange rate because guess what? Other currencies was backed by the dollar. Okay, and the dollar was supposed to be backed by gold. So it was fixed exchange rates. Ever since the dollar became fiat and other countries started to follow suit with their currencies, it all became fiat and it all became a floating system. In 1998, do-it-yourself Forex trading went live online. This was around the time that Chris Terry was starting to truly master the power of Forex. Chris Terry is our CEO. And in 2008, Bitcoin was created, which basically founded cryptocurrency as it is today. Bitcoin is the leader of all cryptocurrencies, so you can see the evolution of money. You can see the power of the dollar, all right, as it went from being totally backed by gold to it becoming eventually a fiat currency, a part of a free-floating system along with other currencies. Now let's talk about the power of Forex. Forex is short for foreign exchange, where you can basically trade one currency for another. Now there's over 5 trillion in transactions traded daily. This is the world's largest financial market. You can capitalize in this market from your smartphone, tablet, or personal computer. and cryptocurrencies can be traded as well. So here's a chart where you can actually look at the FX market, the Forex market, compared to other markets. The New York Stock Exchange, the equities market, the futures market, and here we go, the Forex market. Now here's a travel example of profiting from trading currency. Let's say a person exchanges 500 euro for dollars at $1.40 per euro. The person receives 700 USD and holds it. Now let's just say that the person exchanges the $700 USD for euro at $1.30 per euro. The person now receives 538 euro, therefore profiting 38 euro. If you ever traveled before and had to exchange your home currency for the local currency, this is some of the stuff that can happen because all currencies now are free floating exchange system, right? It's all floating exchange rates, and anything could impact the exchange rate. Major news, certain things that go on with the economy, so on and so forth. There's so many factors that go behind, all right, the constant change in these floating exchange rates